In my opinion, full body tracking is one of the greatest things yet available for VR, though there aren't many games that supports it. It's definitely worth getting it if you have the money or you're into social VR platforms like VRChat, Neo's VR, or whether you just like kicking someone's head in Blade & Sorcery. You still need the money to buy it though. Some people think it's not quite possible to have full body tracking if you have an Oculus headset, but it's far from the truth, and it's quite easy to get it running. On my TikTok, some people have been asking me how do I have full body tracking and index controllers with the Quest 2. So I'm here to help you. Whether you just want to pair your Vive trackers or any other Steam VR track devices like the index controllers, just to flick someone off, I see you. All the hardware you need are base stations placed on the opposite sides of your room and your Vive trackers or Steam VR track controllers. And of course the dongles, make sure you have enough dongles. In my case, I have an HTC Vive, so I leave it plugged in without the HDMI cable so I can use my headset to recognize the two extra controllers. That's how I use 5 Steam VR track devices without needing to buy two more dongles. Now that the intro's over, let's get into it. Also, everything here, you'll find the links for in the video's description down below. Step 0. Find the settings for your Steam VR. By going to Program Files, Steam, Steam Apps, Common, Steam VR, Resources and Settings. And then you're going to open the default.vr settings file with a notepad. Now you're going to modify two lines in it. Require HMD, and you're going to change that from true to false, which is going to make Steam VR recognize your devices without having a headset. And you're also going to change activate multiple drivers from false to true, so you're able to have different headsets connected to your computer other than SteamVR tracked headsets. First, download the Oculus software so you can install the drivers for the headset. Keep in mind you need to plug the Quest 2 to the computer using a USB-C cable, like the Link cable or your Android's phone charger that works too. This step you can probably skip if you just want to use AirLink or just the Link cable, but I highly recommend using Virtual Desktop, because in my experience, you're gonna have a way better tracking using Virtual Desktop. I don't know why this happens, but I think it's because we're skipping the shitty ass Oculus software. That thing sucks, honestly. And we don't like Facebook anyway, let's just skip their terrible software. Keep in mind, Virtual Desktop is a paid software, but it is worth it. To use Virtual Desktop, you're going to need to go to their website and download the Virtual Desktop Streamer app on your computer. Then, get your Quest 2 and open Oculus Quest Store and get the Virtual Desktop app. Now, in this step, you're gonna have to go to GitHub. I'm gonna leave the link in the description like I said before, and you're going to download OpenVR Space Calibrator and install it. What is this? Since Steam and Oculus headsets uses different ways to calculate your position, you're gonna have to use this so you can sync your position of both the base stations and the Oculus headset. You can download the latest version of OpenVR Space Calibrator on this website. OpenVR Space Calibrator is a Steam VR add-on, like the OVR Advanced Settings, which you should get as well, since it gives you the ability to move yourself around without having to actually move. It's really good for VR chat, or if you're just short and need to read something in certain games, like Half-Life Alyx, you know, I'm short, shit. Now that you already have Virtual Desktop in your Quest, and you're already connected to your computer, turn on your trackers or your SteamVR controllers and pair them if needed. If you can't see your trackers at all, connect them with a USB cable to your computer and you should be able to pair them through a wired connection, and you could also update their firmware if it's needed. Now with the headset on, open SteamVR menu and you're gonna see this extra button. Click on it. Now you're looking at its OpenVR Space Calibrator settings. Here you see your list of your Oculus devices on the left and SteamVR devices on the right side. To sync your play space, you just need to select devices you want and then just click start, holding both devices like side by side and start giving it a movement, you know, it's a little twist, a little wave, you know, moving around. In my case, I like to calibrate without the Oculus controllers. I select my headset and my Index controller to calibrate, and that makes me look like this in real life when calibrating. I always have to turn off my Quest controllers to use my Index controllers, and I do that by removing the batteries, since the Oculus doesn't give you the option to turn off the dim controllers. Shame on you, Oculus! I know. If I have someone over, I'll just skip one of my Quest controllers on and calibrate with that instead, so they don't have to watch me do that. Now that you've done everything, you're ready to go. Just open the game and test it out.